The Serrano were originally from the San Bernardino Mountains. They initially moved due to a smallpox outbreak and by the influence of the Spanish, and eventually were forced to move out. They moved to the now Morongo and San Manuel Mission of Indians. The number of Serrano have dwindled in the 20th century to 150 people in the year 1910. Today, there are no longer any speaking members of the native Serrano tongue.
The Serrano Indians have been living in the San Bernardino Mountains and the current-day Joshua Tree National Park for thousands of years. Their happy life ended with the Spanish colonization. In 1905, the American government set up the U.S. Forest Service to administer national parks and national grasslands. As a result, the Serranos were chased out from their homeland to reservation. Their homelands turned into San Bernardino National Forest and Joshua Tree National Monument in 1936. The Joshua Tree National Monument was declared as a national park in 1994 when the U.S. Congress passed the California Desert Protection Act.
The National Environmental Policy Acts of 1969 and the American Indian Religious Freedom Act of 1978 regulated hunting for Native American practices in order to protect animals. Fishing was also regulated on reservations because in order to fish, they required permits and other documents. When the Serranos were relocated, they were forced to adapt to the resources that were on the reservation. The native plant life and resources they left behind on the land that they originally had owned, that now belonged to the government, would be destroyed and exploited for more modern uses.
The Serrano Indians are a people of rich culture, including basket making, pottery, religion, and bird singing. The Serrano people have strongly embraced their culture in the forest and high country, where they inhabited and utilized each component of culture. Globalization had a fading effect on the Serrano Indian culture. However, today, there exists a San Manuel Cultural Awareness and Tribal Unity Program whose mission is to pass on Serrano heritage to future generations.
One problem the Serrano people faced with globalization was education. When the Serrano people were placed on reservations, the U.S. encouraged the Serrano people to get an education. The U.S. gave the Serrano people grants and passed the Indian New Deal, which helped to increase enrollment in schools for the Serrano people. The Morongo Indians have recently opened a Morongo Elementary School, which is the first school to be fully funded by a tribe in the U.S.
The Serrano people under the San Manuel Band of Mission Indians and under the Morongo Band of Mission Indians were poor people. They started their own bingo and card games to bring jobs and income into the reservation. Riverside County tried to shut the games down. The Cabazon Band of Mission Indians fought back, and the case went to Supreme Court. In the case of California versus Cabazon Band of Mission Indians, states did not have the rights to enforce law on gambling on the reservation. Since then, the casino has been expanded.
The impact of globalization has and continues to be very prominent in the Serrano culture. The Serrano people have assimilated into mainstream American culture, and their culture is slowly fading away. The Serrano tribe has invested into modernization in the form of casinos. The Serrano people are a part of the San Manuel Band of Mission Indians and have a casino in the Inland Empire and Highland. And also the Serrano people belong to the Morongo tribe and have a casino in Cabazon.
Thank you. We know the difference between the reality of freedom and the illusion of freedom. There's a way to live with Earth and a way not to live with Earth. We choose the way of Earth.
Because your government pushed our people off this land years ago, Ray. And Milton and his goons are making sure that we don't come back.